Coming up, we'll take a closer look at Windows Virtual Desktop now in public preview to give your users the only Windows 10 multi-session experience, virtualized in the cloud and available on any device. Now we're going to show you how it delivers the best office experience with multi-session virtual scenarios, and stay tuned for a sneak peek of the next generation admin experience in the Azure portal. I'm joined once again by Scott Manchester, who leads the desktop virtualization team at Microsoft. Welcome back and congrats on the public preview.
Yeah, thanks, Jeremy. It's a great milestone that we have reached. We hope to learn a lot from you and progress quickly through the preview and get to general availability of the service.
All right, so what's new and exciting with Windows Virtual Desktop?
We got a lot of new things to show here, Jeremy. If you're a user, we focused on giving you the full Windows 10 and Office productivity experience. And regardless of the virtualization deployment type, whether it's a single or multi-session environment, whether it's based on client or server, it's all delivered through Azure. And if you're an IT admin, you can now manage all of this in Azure using one service.
Right, and you're talking about the end user experience. How has that then been enhanced?
Well, that's a great place to start. We've made progress across all our clients, but let's start with the Windows experience. So here I am on my Windows 10 device, and I'm using the new Windows Virtual Desktop client application.
Right.
Now, the cool thing about this application is it can run all the way from Windows 7 all the way through Windows 10. Now, here you can see all the apps and desktops that my IT admin has provisioned for me. And I can launch them right here through this application, but they've also been fully integrated into the Start menu. So if I go here and bring up my Start menu, you can see all of these applications are right here. Now, if I want to launch an app, let's say Word, and here you can see that it's running down in my taskbar, and the only thing that really indicates that it's a virtualized app is the fact that it has this little glyph over it. Now watch this, if I right-click on it, I can say pin to taskbar, and now I can actually close that app, and you can see that it still remains here on my taskbar, and it looks like all my other Windows apps. Mm-hmm. So I'll go ahead and launch it again, and you'll see again, it pops up quickly. Now this app looks and feels just like a local app, so I can snap it, I can take this thing and run it full screen, and I can even copy and paste between other local applications with this. So it looks and feels like just any other application on my Windows desktop.
Now, traditionally, if you're deploying VDI, the challenge has been that maybe if you're using Office or Outlook, a lot of those applications require persistent storage and really kind of a one VM to per user environment to work kind of in the way they were designed.
Yeah, Outlook and other Office applications traditionally require data persistence to provide the best experience. However, the most common configuration for virtualized environments is non-persistent host pools.
Right. And this is one of those things where you need to use non-persistent multi-user sessions because it's less expensive. You can get more than one user on a VM. It's a lot more efficient than running it kind of in that one-to-one scenario.
Yeah, you're right. And now with WVD, we can enable the best of both worlds. I can now deploy Windows 10 Enterprise multi-session and have that rich Office experience. And this is enabled by FS Logic Technologies. We recently acquired this technology and integrated it into Windows Virtual Desktop. So now your Office and other applications and other data can roam with you. Let me show you this in action.
All right, let's take a look.
So here I've also remoted into a full Windows 10 Enterprise multi-user environment. Now I'm going to prove this to you, Jeremy. I'm going to right-click here, go to the Task Manager, and I'll click on this User tab. And here you can see there's a number of users remoted into the same machine at the same time.
Yep.
So we're running Windows 10 multi-user. And now I'm going to go ahead and launch Outlook, just like I would on any other desktop. And you'll notice here that Outlook actually loads really fast. And not only does it load quickly, but it actually will automatically be hydrated with all of my OST.
Yeah, and just as kind of as context here, normally if you did this without hosted cache, you would have to pull all of that down from Exchange Online, for example, in this case, and hydrate out your inbox.
Yeah, you'd be waiting here for a while for it to transact and load all your inbox. And the other cool thing is if I do a quick search here, you'll note that my inbox is also indexed. So I can quickly do a search across all of my OST and find files or emails that I'm looking for. And as you mentioned, let me show you how this is configured here. If I go under File and bring up my account settings, I want to show you that I'm actually running in Outlook cached mode. So I'm running just how I would on any other machine.
Very cool. And the beauty here with FS Logix is actually we've containerized the user profile data. And we can attach that then in real time to the session that you get brokered to, even if you've never seen that VM before.
Yeah, you're right. So normally I might be logging into a different VM each time. So I get routed to a different VM in a host pool. Mm-hmm. But we'll mount that storage to whatever VM you happen to be logged into. And it looks like it's persistent and running from the C drive.
Right. So that's Outlook. What about other Office applications? Do they benefit as well?
So another limitation with multi-session environments has been supporting OneDrive. With FS Logic technology, I now have full access to my OneDrive in non-persistent multi-session deployments. Mm-hmm. Let me show you a demo.
Let's take a look.
So here I'm back on my Windows 10 multi-user desktop, and you can see in the system tray that I'm running the OneDrive sync client. Now, if I bring up my OneDrive folder, I want to show you, you can see which files are actually still in the cloud. Some of these files are actually synced here locally. And then here's another file that I've actually pinned to say, make it always available.
So it's files on demand.
Files on demand, exactly. So now if I want to load a file that's still in the cloud, let's pick this one here. It's a rather large file. You'll note that this file can copy very quickly across to my machine and launch into PowerPoint. And it was really a seamless experience, even though that file wasn't actually originally stored on this machine.
Okay, so there's a few different pieces at play here. We saw FS Logics in terms of mounting the storage and the files on demand working, and it's attaching to OneDrive in this case. So why don't you explain what works behind the scenes here to get this working?
So here's how this works. I have a 1 terabyte of storage as part of my Office subscription, mm-hmm. and this content is all hosted in OneDrive. And the OneDrive sync client and the Windows 10 Enterprise multi-session both work together to support OneDrive files on demand. So because of this, I can set up a much smaller user profile disk and let OneDrive cache my most recently addressed files or always available file. Now, when I want to access an on-demand file, it immediately hydrates. And this uses the high-speed networking infrastructure across the Microsoft cloud to ensure files move as fast as possible, become locally available, and then I'm able to access that file locally.
This looks really great, but what happens if I'm on a device that doesn't have, or I don't have the ability to install a native WVD client?
Well, we have native client apps for every major platform, Windows, Mac, iOS, and Android, and even an HTML5 client. So Jeremy, your computer doesn't have a native client installed. Why don't you show us what that experience looks like from a browser?
Sure. So here I'm logged into a browser. I've got all of my apps provisioned for me by IT, even some desktops here, and kind of the same experiences that I can launch. I'm going to launch the full desktop in this case. And here you can see that Windows 10 shows up. One of the cool things that I like is if I actually press this little button here, it's now full screen. It's going to respect the host device resolution settings and everything. So now I've got a full Windows 10 experience. And I can go ahead and click on apps. So now, even though I'm in a browser, I can launch another browser here, like Edge in this case. And everything just works as you would expect. So we've seen the desktop experience, but how would this work then on other mobile platforms?
Everyone's mobile today, and they want to connect to corporate resources on any device. And Windows Virtual Desktop is the premier platform for delivering Windows apps and desktops to these users. Now, while we provide the same great experience across all major platforms, let me show you how this works on Samsung DeX. So here I have a Samsung Note 9 attached to this display here through a USB-C cable.
Okay.
And I've also paired it with a Bluetooth keyboard and a Bluetooth mouse. But I can actually interoperate with this experience using the phone itself, or again, my Bluetooth mouse. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back to our main menu in our remote desktop client app here. And here you can see all those same resources that my IT admin has provisioned for me. And I can click over here and see the apps and the full desktops. So what I want to do is actually remote into that same session that I was logged into on my PC. So now I'm running that same session I was on my desktop. I might have traveled halfway across the world. Now I have that same Windows experience on a different device, and all I needed to carry with me was a small phone.
And I can see how this would be really beneficial for people that use maybe different locations or work from different areas, kind of in a mobile workspace scenario.
Yeah, there's a large trend around mobile office environments, leveraging shared spaces and hot desking. And this can be a great fit for contractors, law enforcement officers, and the road warriors that need the occasional touchdown space to be productive.
Mm-hmm. So that's Android. What's new for iOS?
Well, if you use an iOS device, you'll also have a great new experience with the new version of the remote desktop client available today in test flight. Now, this works with the latest iOS devices, and we've also extended the capability to enable mouse support through a partnership with SwiftPoint.
Okay, so let's put that little mouse to work.
So let me show you here. So on this iPad, I've got the latest version of the remote desktop client loaded. Okay. And here you can see that I have all those same resources that I saw on my Windows PC and the Android device mm-hmm. available to me here. So let's go ahead and launch that same Windows 10 multi-session, this time from the iPad. So here we are back at that same desktop. And now I can interact with this in the same way I can in the past using touch. But now I can also use this mouse. And between this mouse and the Apple keyboard, I've got another rich experience here. So I've got this full Windows desktop experience that's mobile. I can take it with me wherever I want and use whatever device I want to have the same access to those apps and desktops that I had available on my Windows PC.
Very cool. So it's really great to see how Windows Virtual Desktop breaks down all the barriers on both the user experience side across mobile devices and personal devices, and even in the browser. Now, the team's really been cranking on new stuff, but what's new on the management side?
What I'm about to show you is not in the preview, but I want to give you an early view of what's coming for the Azure Portal integration for Windows Virtual Desktop.
All right, let's do it.
So here I'm logged into the Azure Portal, and I'm actually looking at the tenant that was hosting the demos that we saw earlier. So I can see all the host pools that have been created by my IT admin here. Now, each of these host pools could have been configured for a different group of users. Perhaps my engineering department has a set of host pools hosting applications for them. There might be a host pool group for my accounting department. Let's drill into one of these here and kind of take a look at some of the settings that we can apply here. So note, one of the first things I see as I drill into this host pool is this option to download a registration key. Now, this is a cool feature that allows me to actually take an existing set of VMs that might be running in Azure and a resource group and add those to this host pool. So that's one method of extending the host pool capabilities, adding new machines. But I can also drill into machines here, and I can actually, through this UI, if I had the right privileges, I could add additional VMs and have them provisioned into Azure and added to this host pool in an automated way. Now you can see here, I can also see the number of users I have connected. I can see if the machines are on or off, and if they're in drain mode. I can also drill into app groups. And in this particular host pool, I'm hosting the desktops. In fact, this is the one that we were connecting to earlier, having the full desktop experience with Windows 10. But also through this UX, I can set up groups of apps. So I can install a collection of apps on the VM and set up a collection, specific collection for one user or group of users and another set for a different set of users. So this makes it a lot easier for an IT admin not to have a giant collection of VMs that they need to manage. I can customize the apps that I'm hosting for different users. So again, this will provide a very rich experience for IT admins to work within the Azure portal to manage and deploy Windows Virtual Desktop.
Very cool. So right there within the Azure portal, you can manage your WVD along with all the different Azure services that you might be using day-to-day, like Azure Active Directory and others.
Yeah, and of course, you can hook into your current automation solutions by using our templates and our REST APIs. We have a rich set of tools we've provided for IT admins to deploy and manage Windows Virtual Desktop.
Very cool. So how else can people go and learn more about Windows Virtual Desktop?
Well, this is an exciting day for us. We've announced the public preview, and I encourage everybody to go sign up and start kicking the tires on this now.
Great stuff. Thanks for joining us today, Scott. And of course, keep watching Microsoft Mechanics for the latest tech updates. Hit subscribe if you haven't already, and we'll see you next time.